My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant.
From this day, all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he remembered his promise of mercy.
The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever.
About 15 years ago, when the university was founded, before the first shovel went in the ground, I had received from Father Fessio and Ignatius Press a direct mail piece promoting the university and asking for people that would support the university. So I was part of that original Founders Club back then, and the entire concept of the university I have loved since the day that first shovel went in the ground. My son has graduated from here in 2020. He always had a strong love for our Lord and commitment to our Lord. But I would say what really impacted what I saw was the community, the friendships that he had. He got married a little over a year ago, and probably six of his groomsmen he met because he came to this university. He would not have met them if he wasn't here. You know, they're all, I don't know, 22, 21, 23 years old. They were in the basement, and I hear one of them say to the other guys, hey, let's all pray the rosary. And I thought to myself when I heard that, I would have never done that when I was his age with my friends. But these guys are going to help get each other to heaven. This campus is just very blessed with so many students that are like that. And it's the community, it's those friendships that will go with him for the rest of his life. That I don't know any place else where you're going to meet those types of people and love for each other, and love for each other's souls.
We join our voices to that of all the generations who call you blessed. We celebrate in you the works of God, who never tires of looking down with mercy upon humanity, except with the benevolence of a mother, the act of consecration that the Ave Maria University community performs today with confidence before this image of you that is so dear to us. We venerate you as the patroness of our university and of the Americas. Entrust us to your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and help us to follow him as his joyful, intentional followers in the world today. Our Lady of Guadalupe, Our Lady of the Annunciation, Amen.
I made my Marian consecration in the 90s. It was St. Louis de Montfort's True Devotion. So I made the consecration, and my whole life turned. Years later, I read from St. John Paul II, when asked, what was the turning point in your life? You would have thought he would have said, oh, when I was ordained a priest, or when I became a bishop, or when I became a cardinal, or when I became the pope. It was none of those things. The turning point in his life was when he made his Marian consecration. Our Blessed Mother wants people to consecrate themselves and entrust themselves to her. It has been a foundation for everything we do. When I first accepted the position here, one of the first acts we did was we sent a letter out to all the students, the faculty, administration, the staff, and the parents, inviting them to join us in making this Marian consecration. So everything was consecrated to her. This is her university. We're here to serve her in that sense. I was just overwhelmed by how many people joined in making this or renewing their Marian consecration. From the day I stepped foot on the campus on February 1st, so I've only been here a short time, it has just been just such a joy. The joy in the students that I meet, the staff, the faculty, the parents of the students, and just the people in the town. I mean, I don't think there's a place like this on earth where you have an entire town named Ave Maria, Florida. There's about 7,500 to 10,000 people in the town, and a university That's our Blessed Mother's University, all in one place. And it's really all because of one man's yes.
A lot of people say that I lost my big fortune, but I don't see it that way. I feel that my fortune is you, and you're striving to get to heaven.